Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. I'm going live again on Facebook, on the radio show as well. I'm just waiting for the radio show itself to kick in. They're just in the adverts just now. So we'll be live on the radio very shortly. And Bill is just doing his advert. And then we're going to get the show started. So if you're already joining me, you know, and you have some questions, you got some comments, just bring it on air and we'll talk about it, because you, the listener, are the most important ones. So it's about another 30 seconds away, but we're going to talk about networking today, an interesting subject, and I'm excited to be here. You know, last week was the first time I tried Facebook as well, even though it's a radio show. I see you too. even though it's a radio show, we thought, well, we'll give it another aspect as well. It's if people can actually connect with us on Facebook as well and on YouTube, it's going to be even more possible. My music is on just now. I'm just hearing it. So I'm seeing they're running 1 minute different from the times that I have here in Europe. But it doesn't matter. We're going live just now. And yes, good morning. You are listening to IBGR.network, the International Business Growth Radio Network. And I'm your host, Jan Roberts, global influencer, co-founder of Key Leadership Institute, founder of JR Speakers Club, and I'm also a coach, trainer, speaker, values-based leadership specialist, personal profiling consultant, and personal development professional. But for more information about me, go to the IBGR.website and check out my profile there. You'll find all the links and to follow me and get in touch with me. The good thing is, we're not only, if you're on Facebook just now, you've already realized, but on the radio, if you're not only, if you've got access to Facebook as well, then you can watch me as well. Even though it's a radio station, we have a few different avenues to make sure that even not only the listener, but also the viewers can connect with us. So if you've got any questions, because we would actually love to hear from you in real time, as we are just now. So if you're listening live or even to the recordings afterwards, you can always connect and interact with us on social media. That is Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, and Twitter on IBGR.network. Now, because this is Facebook just now as well, if you've got any comments or if you've got any questions you have, if I can't answer them right here, I will certainly answer them afterwards. But the good thing is that your questions are important to us, and you can interact with us all the time. So it's exciting to be here, and this is now episode 10 of season 3 already, where I'm going to talk about your network is your net worth, not your nightmare. And it is on the People Skills Lane, People for Success. Now, you can also download my show notes for today on the www.ibgr.network, where they've already been posted by Donna. She's already supporting me here, and it's an ungodly hour of 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 6 o'clock now in America, in some places at least, and she's still enjoying her first cup of coffee. Well, Donna, I've just had mine, my second one, but it's an exciting season for a variety of reasons, because what's going to happen this time is that we always wanted it, but especially now we want the audience to ask questions on each episode, each session from each show host and the respective subjects, with wide-ranging subjects from operations, customers, finance, today's show about people, and tomorrow's show is about owners as executive and working on the business rather than in the business. Now, the good thing is, we're on 24/7. We have now about 50 show hosts around the world, and we're on 24/7. So there's always something that you can actually learn, that you can take away, that can help your business in a variety of areas. So I hope you are with us, and I hope you will. Now on Facebook, I can definitely say this, but even with the radio, you can share this as well. But like and share it on Facebook as well. When you hear things and when you connect further with other people who are also starting to do Facebook Lives, there's quite a few of them already. So you can join us. You can also connect with others. you can ask questions, but like and share it, because there's always somebody you'll listen to or you hear from and say, hey, this might be good for them, whether it's the financial side, whether it's the people side, the organizational side, whichever side it is. But there's enough for everybody, and enough that we want your questions, because next season it's going to be a totally on-demand radio show where you will decide what we talk about. I mean, at the moment you kind of decide anyway, but through questions that have already been asked and through studies that's been done. But next season is going to be real you. And you are always important to us, but you're going to decide what we talk about. You're going to stretch us. And I love that. You know, so please join us and ask questions. So as I said, today we'll talk about wasting time when not networking strategically, and the need for relationship building, and why networking does not have to be a nightmare. You know, if this is your first time listening, welcome. And if you're a returning listener, welcome back. And if it's, I can now say, if you're a first-time viewer, very same, welcome to you. And if you are a returning viewer after I did it last week, also, welcome back. We appreciate you being here. And, you know, by the end of this time together, you will kind of understand more why it's important to, as a business owner or an entrepreneur, to know where, when, and how to network, build relationships, and become more effective with your time. Now, it's an absolutely fantastic that we now have more people from around 145 countries. I don't know if it's grown since last week, but 145 countries already are listening in to not just me, but the wide variety of show hosts every single week. So thank you, thank you, thank you, and like and share this, people. So there have always been an abundance of opportunities to attend network sessions, conferences, and a wide variety of other meetings and sessions. But the effectiveness of those leaves a lot to be desired. So we all know that in the modern business environment, networking is important. Yet, how many of us actually know how to network properly? See, the truth is hardly any of us do. Most people associate networking with awkward attempts to chat with a colleague at a dinner party, or with a competitor at a conference, or even a stranger somewhere, but it results in a bad experience. Many of us therefore many of us deliberately avoid the whole process of networking and assume that we are so good at it, or that we are no good at it when it's awkward. And that's when it becomes a nightmare, when we already assume that we're no good at it every time we have to go. Oh, do we have to go to another one of them? But if you can make it better for yourself and learn something and take away something, it will and become more effective. So you don't need to go to every session, but you need to be more strategic about this. But the view of networking is kind of false, because there is so much more to the process than we think. Understanding the process will give you the skills and information you need to become a more strategic networker. And that's also what we're going to talk into. So if you've got questions about it, ask the questions. I've got a kind of schedule, but I'm very flexible, bend over backwards. But if you have anything, let us know and we'll talk into it, and we'll try to answer your questions. And if I can't answer them, because I'm not Google and I don't know everything, that's why I learn when you ask me questions as well, and I stretch myself, I will certainly get back to you. But are these as effective or ineffective physical get-togethers? Because we are going online as well. See, the opportunities have not diminished. In fact, I would say they've actually grown by virtual conferences, because you can attend them from the comfort of your home. But are they really as effective as physical get-togethers? Well, after all, we cannot meet face-to-face, so it's often a Zoom call, a webinar, or other electric get-togethers. Well, I was recently at an international Maxwell certification event, where we had 6,000 people online, and speed working session, networking sessions. I'd never experienced them, but they were 2 minutes each. And what it did was it actually gave people a chance to meet face to face on camera, but within 2 minutes. So you had to be very quick and very strategic. So you had to. Some people just didn't know what to do, and they got caught in the headlights, and before they realized the lights went out again 2 minutes later. But really, once you got the hang of it over the 4 days, it was amazing, because you meet many people, and it was stunning, first ever virtual event, and of course a roaring success. But that way you could connect with people, and then the networking really starts after. But it was an initial connection, 2 minutes, which is brilliant. But what about real connections? What about possible collaborations, finding strategic partners, or indeed our much-needed customers? Now, most of the time, it has little to do with what type of event you attend, but far more with you, the person walking into that event. Yes, you. See, do you know why you're even there? Now, I know that might surprise you, but if I stood at the door of a networking event and asked you what your intentions were before you walked in the door, could you actually tell me? Now, that's interesting because many people probably think that it would be nice just to go to a meeting, to have some breakfast or a cup of coffee and see what happens. Now, that is not very effective if you're actually going to a networking session. It's not just about meeting people and walking away and, oh, have a good time, I had whatever happened. No, that is where so often the challenges are. And that's why, oh, the sun is coming out as well. How bright. I might even have to, see, I'm going half and half now. The radio can't see that, of course, but we go to the meetings for a variety of interesting and some less interesting people we meet. We walk away with a handful of business cards, then go home, put them aside, the phone or laptop, and hope those people who in just a few days we can barely remember, as you've already attended so many other events since. So you hope those stunning contacts will contact you from you to benefit, yours especially. And you are once again disappointed when there is a deafening silence from your mobile and no emails come flooding in with a request for your products or services. So what is wrong with these people? Why are they not calling? What else can I do? Now, that is a better question, really. Funny you should ask. We will discuss this in the session after our first commercial break. But there's others who go around personal development weekends where they will change their fortunes around. Life-changing it was, the same as the last four or five. Yes, you guessed it, nothing changes. So when nothing changes, nothing changes. That might be, it might not be as profound, but it is true. It is fairly obvious, but tell that to the tell that to the networking conference and life-changing weekend junkies or groupies, because people keep turning up, but no intentions, no idea what they're really there for. Just want to be amongst people. But there are people who attend just a two-hour event, and everything changes in their life from the minute they walk out of the door. In fact, really, to be honest, for the minute they walk into the door. So, networking is more important today than it ever has been, which means that developing networking skills is paramount for today's workers. You can become a strategic networker by leveraging your contacts in new and creative ways and fully committing to your networking identity. Now, it takes time. To build these powerful networks takes time. And we're going to talk a little bit more into what networking actually is. We're talking about Ivan Meisner's BNI network and how he recommends we do networking in the last session. But we'll go through this. But first of all, we are going to take a commercial break for 2 to 3 minutes, and the radio will have the adverts on. But don't go away. And after the session, we'll start talking right into this, and we're looking for your questions, we're looking for your comments. But don't go away, we'll be back in 2 to 3 minutes. So now what really happens is I'm still on Facebook, of course, pale face at the moment with a bright sun just coming through behind the clouds in sunny Scotland. At the moment, of course, as it is a radio station, we have adverts. We have some music. In fact, you might even be able to hear it. That's my jingle. You might as well hear what actually happens because it's a radio show, so. Hope you can hear that.
Slot in our 6-hour show cycle, contact the station director, and that is at programming info@bgr.network. We will respond to your email within one business day. Thanks for listening, and don't miss this great opportunity to put the world back to work and grow with us. Thanks.
Can you hear that?
Is your CRM making your business grow? When surveyed, about 90% of business leaders admit that their CRM is...
Because this way, of course, with the adverts, they can't hear me, but on Facebook you can.
Don't use their CRM the way they should. Why not? Well, it takes them too much time and discipline to fill out their CRM completely. And if salespeople don't, the CRM system becomes useless. That's why when we started Salesware, we asked ourselves, what if we build a CRM system that fills out itself? What if we build a system that surfaces existing data so that you know and remember all about your customers and never forget and disappoint another lead? That's what Salesware does today. It pulls in all the data buried in your emails, email signatures, calendar, phone, social data, company database, email and web tracking, and offers it to you in an easy way so you and your CRM are always up to date. Want to see this for yourself? Head to salesware.com and get your free trial.
And that is my start to the next one. So I thought, rather than me interfering, I wanted you to listen in to see what actually happens. And then I'll shut this down again pretty rapidly. And yes, and here we are live again. So that's what happens for those who are on radio. We're on Facebook Live as well, so I let them experience what happens, what the radio listeners actually listen to. And I thought there's no point for our Facebook watchers, listeners and watchers, not to be able to experience that either. So I just had the same stuff going on Facebook rather than talk through it. Just to let them experience that's the radio show. But we're back. You're now listening to IBGR Network, and you're watching it as well if you're on Facebook. IBGR is our call sign as a radio station, but we're much more than a radio station. We are a network of global entrepreneurs coming together to create a shared space for collaboration and business success. Yes, your success is important to us. And I'm your host, Jan Roberts, Global Influencer. This is episode 10 already, and if you hadn't been able to join us so far, what we're talking about this hour is your network is your net worth. You might have all heard that, but it's not your nightmare. At least it doesn't have to be. It's in the People Skills Lane for Success. And you can also go to our website, www.ibgr.network, and download the show notes, which Donna so kindly has put up already yesterday. But you can do more there as well. You can actually download the show notes, but you can actually download podcasts as well. All of those you can put on. You can meet all the other show hosts and find their podcast and find when they're on air, because we're on air 24/7. But there's something else, and I'm going to put my glasses on for that, I think. Yes, it's small writing. Donna just let me inform. But it's now also available in the IBGR community. So if you're listening or watching, I'm just reading this because it just came up. There you go. Updated all the time by our amazing support system. Now available in the IBGR community mentoring groups. So when you join the IBGR community, you're automatically added to your community of commerce. So the community of commerce is a great place to network and connect with our entire community. As I just said, there's so many of us there already. You can also join your favorite on-air talent mentoring group. Joining mentoring groups gives you access to useful tools and mentoring conversations around your specific business challenges. Join one or more mentoring groups today and start engaging with like-minded business growers and entrepreneurs. So there you have it, fresh off the press, from our support team, Donna Kundi and Bill Eastman, who are always on hand to support and guide and help us. They've started this 3 seasons ago, and it's already, as I said, in 145 countries around the world. I can take the glasses off again now. The glasses come off. Watch out. In this session, I just want you to have to talk a little bit about what happened to me one event six and a half years ago now. And it was IMC, this International Maxwell event, in August 2014. And I went there, and as I said, you know, when you go to a networking event, if you become more intentional, you've got a better chance of achieving something. In fact, you should achieve something when you go there intentional. There is, you know, you can't leave it to chance if you just wander in and see what happens. That's why you waste time, and that's why you get so frustrated, because nothing did happen. Now, you didn't even set an intention. You didn't even say why you went there. But go with the intentions. I want to meet this kind of people. I want to meet these kind of clients. I want to meet whatever kind of people you need to connect with. Set an intention. And I did. When I went there from Scotland, where I am just now, and hopefully all being well, I should next week I should be back in South Africa. Yay! I'll be with Arthi, who's my partner, my business partner, and our fellow host, who's on in a couple hours' time here as well. So don't miss that either. But I went there with a specific intention to find somebody in Africa I could collaborate or partner with. Now you might say that's not very specific. Now there was 3,000 people there, so to find somebody who I could collaborate or partner with, that was my intention. I didn't know a specific person, but what happened was, of course, as you know now, already I just gave the game away there, but I connected with Arthi and we started talking. We had a shared vision. We know our purpose was the same. We already started to feel that we build that relationship as you know, we connected on a deeper level than just, oh, here's a business card. And no, I always came home with a stack of business cards, and honestly, what I should have done was taken a photo with the business card so I know who it came from. But difficult to remember too many people. Oh, there's the sun out again. Oh, look me pale face. On radio, I now look like a real pale face. But anyway, we actually started talking about what our visions were and why we were there and what our future should look like. And we found out we had a lot in common. So we not only that, but we kept that connection going for a long time afterwards. And we started building this connection deeper and deeper. We talked about all kinds of things, including business and what we wanted to do for entrepreneurs, what we wanted to do for leaders. And well, I'd already left my job as well and to become an entrepreneur. And Arthi has never been anything but an amazing entrepreneur. She's got 3 or 4 different businesses, training companies and her own. She's now writing a book as well. But I really connected with Arthi. But also very important that to keep that connection going, to build the relationship. That is only the connection is at first. What happens afterwards is you need to build a relationship, which I'll certainly talk into. But the rest is history. As I said, we started the Key Leadership Institute together, and we're now building a global organization where we are positively impacting people in a variety of areas, including entrepreneurship, leadership, communication, behavior analysis, values-based leadership, coaching, training, speaking. It's wonderful to be joining forces, and we're joining forces in all kinds of different ways in collaborations, which I've already talked more into as well in the previous one. But yeah, so that is something that happened. I set the intentions and here we are 6 years later. It is exciting and life is exciting even in challenging times. But as I mentioned before the break already, many people are simply wasting their time going around networking meetings, conferences and seminars, and are really becoming professional meet and greeters really. Well, this is often not because they know, but because they simply do not know how to network effectively. Now, there is several reasons why nothing really happens after those sessions. One of them is lack of network and know-how, as I just said already. And also lack of communication skills. Now, this skill you can and must master. Because if you're an entrepreneur, if you're a business owner, you need to learn to communicate more effectively and better. And that includes even on networking, but how to communicate with your clients, how to communicate with partners, how to communicate with funders and all kinds of people. It needs to be effective, it needs to be better. So we need to constantly upgrade ourselves. Lack of importance of the need to network. See, especially in the sessions where you're just starting out, you're developing your ideas and all that kind of stuff. You haven't got your doors open yet. So, and even when you first open your door, you're on your own, there's no priority. Yeah, so much else has to be done in the early phases and no one else is doing those things but the person looking in the mirror. And it's challenging enough when you go, especially when you go from an employee to an entrepreneur. Totally different mindset, as I found out a long time ago. And I've come to terms with it a lot now, but it took me a while. And if it hadn't been for Arthi, who knows where I would have been now. But lack of relationship building is another one. So we will talk about this more a little bit later, but it is also very important, and lack of discipline. See, consistent action over time compounds, as does lack of action, by the way. So to do that, you must be done. To do actually what must be done is an imperative every single day. You might have heard of the quote, if you want something that others don't have, do something that others don't do. And, you know, consistency and discipline are key components of your business at any stage. So that is very important. And lack of leadership skills. Now you say, I'm only on my own, I don't need leadership skills. Self-leadership, all leadership skills begin with self-leadership. So you need to really watch and learn, because self-leadership is all about self-development. What does your growth plan look like again? Exactly. If you haven't got one, that is also a big problem. But you need to develop your leadership skills, your self-leadership. Lead yourself first. You can't give what you haven't got. So you need to learn to lead yourself. And on the next, after the break, we're also going to talk a little bit about contact spheres. Now, you might have never heard about contact spheres, but that was a list at least of many things why networking is so ineffective. But you might never have heard of a contact spheres, and I'll give you just a quick overview before the break anyway, which is coming up fairly rapidly. A contact sphere is a group of business professionals who have a symbiotic professional relationship. They are compatible, non-competitive professions, such as a lawyer, a CPA, a financial planner, and a banker. Now, if you put all these four in a room for an hour, they're going to do business together. So yeah, maybe, I'll hide a little bit from the sun. So I hope you get that, because each one is working with clients that have similar needs but require different services. Now, hence, they're working with that symbiotic relationship. I hope that makes any sense. Another example of a contact sphere is a caterer, a florist, the photographer, and a travel agent. Now, you can see how they come together, because someone called this the wedding mafia. I love that term, the wedding mafia. But if one gets a referral to a wedding, then they all get the referral to the wedding. See, these professions, more than most, have truly learned how to work their contact spheres. Okay, one last one. Contractors, for example. So if you have a painter, a carpenter, a plumber, a landscaper, electricians, and interior designers, you get it. It doesn't have to be three or four. It can be any amount of those that have similar interests. And you can hear in each one of these three I just mentioned that they have similar interests but not the same job. But that's why they need to connect with each other so they can work as a group. And powerful. You go to the group, somebody need a house built. Here we are. Everybody's here. What do you need? And you can refer each other as well. I'm going to talk about that also actually in Ivan Mesner's BNI networking recommendations in the last session. But I hope you get that idea as well. So then you have relationship building is a very important point, because effective networking and long-term success of your business rely on relationship building. And many entrepreneurs and business owners, especially in the early stages, they don't often, they think there's an exclusivity to that kind of stuff, that they don't develop it, they don't focus enough on it, and they are kind of struggling because they haven't built those relationships on the go. Now, already it is just about time to have a break again, and as you know, we will talk in the next session even more about networking. But if you've got any questions, if you've got any comments, just keep them coming. Like and share this, because I'm going to really talk into why and how you could network effectively, including Ivan Meisner's networking formula. So don't go away and come back afterwards. Take care. Now, of course, we're still Facebook Live, and I could grab the radio again and let you listen, but I can talk a little bit more into this as well, and on Facebook Live, the radio listeners, they have their advert to go on now in the little jinglies. But for all of us, networking is important. I mean, it's networking is sometimes maybe a bit official, but it's just creating relationships, building relationships, connecting with people. You know, now even more so than ever before, we should really network with each other, because there's a lot of people who are very lonely in the situation we find ourselves in. And if you can network with people now, if you can learn to network the skills with people, you know, next door, go and knock on the door. There's many people who don't even know the people who live in their own street, not even in their own building. You know, go and knock on some doors, or give them a call, or put a little note under the door. You know, are you okay? It starts with something simple usually, and maybe it's the intention is just to be kind and be nice. That's where also a lot of networking starts. And you never know who you can connect with. And it's not about intentional network, and so you will make connections that will do business with you. You can even start in your neighborhood to just connect better. You can practice this before you walk into a networking session. You know, I'm going to talk a little bit more about it anyway, as I said, but you can practice all this kind of networking stuff where we need to touch heart to heart. See, if we can become really good at it without, at the moment when we have to connect with the people around us, like our family, like our friends, like, as I said, the neighbors, the community, there is no ulterior motive. And that is where networking really happens. When we actually go to a networking session without an ulterior motive, I said intentions, but not in ulterior motives. I will talk about it with in the fourth session with the BNI training. But the idea is that you connect with people first. So you can do that because there is no real idea of creating business when you are at home, when you are in your community, when you are with friends. Yes, it doesn't mean that you can't talk about your business, but normally you talk about everything, and that's how you build connections. You know, get people to know you first. And I'll talk into that very shortly. I'm already going to have a little look to see what the clock says to me. And I am just about ready again for my little jingle, I think. In fact, there you go. That means we're ready for the radio again. So we are back on radio now again. Welcome back. You are listening to IBGR.network. IBGR is a call sign as the radio station, but we're of course much more than a radio station. We're even a viewing station now. But I mean, we are a radio station, but we are a network in 145 countries already in the last, and this is only season 3. So I'm your host, Jan Roberts, Global Influencer, and this is episode number 10 already of season 3. How time flies. But your network is your net worth, not your nightmare. So we're talking about this in the People Lane Skills, People for Success at IBGR.network. Now you can actually go to the website www.ibgr.network and download our show notes. Now if you've just joined us, we're now also in the IBGR page on Facebook. We're live, so you can even see me, even though I've got a face made for radio. You can see me anyway, and you can leave comments there as well. But if you go to the website, you can actually, there's a pulsating question mark there where you can actually leave questions. You can ask questions, leave questions, ask questions, even give us comments, because next season you will decide what we talk about. You're on the on-demand radio station. It's really coming to life next season when you decide what we talk about and what we cover. So this is your big chance. It's all about you anyway, but it's going to be even more about you when we talk about what is really important, what's really worrying, what's really important, and that you need to know. So in that case, let's move on a little bit. I mean, I talked a little bit about contact spheres, what they are and how they work in the last session. And I want to explain a little bit more how to go about developing your spheres. Now, what you have to do is to develop those spheres. And if you weren't there yet, a contact sphere is where a lot of people, a lot of businesses can work together who've got similar but not the same business. So not two joining companies, but a joiner, a plasterer, a plumber, an electrician. These businesses can all come together for the good of each other and you know, go together to a job and refer each other. But again, BNI one, I'll talk into referrals a lot more. But that's the kind of things where you get contact spheres. I hope that makes sense if you just started watching or listening. Now, you have to identify as many professions as possible that fit within your company's contact sphere. So as I just said, the plumber, the electrician, the plasterer, the joiner, those kind of things. But take a look at what professions your industry tends to work with to get an idea of the repetitive and reciprocal referrals. Create a list of those professionals. Then identify specific individuals who would fit into your contact sphere. Now go to various networking groups or consult your business card file and database, even your yellow pages if you have one of them. It'll tell in your area who's what. So if you do this locally, you can do this internationally as well, but not so much the plumber and the joiner, but you don't have to be restricted to your own area. I mean, it depends how far you're willing to travel to do those kind of businesses, but whatever it is, you decide, you know. Of course, like lawyers and CPAs and those kind of people, they can work virtually much easier. And it's difficult to do your plumbing virtually, but you get the picture anyway. So Then you invite these people to participate in networking groups with you so you can formalize your relationship and have a way to stay in regular contact building relationships, because maintaining the relationship is key. And a good way to do that is to participate in groups that put together on a regular basis. So don't just walk away from a session where you've met these people and that. No, get together regularly and talk about these kind of things. Evaluate the professionals in your contact sphere that you are presently referring. If they are not reciprocating, because it's all about that as well. If they're not reciprocating, you may have the wrong profession in the or the wrong person. But fill the spot with someone who is willing to reciprocate. Again, BNI always talks about it, and we're going to talk about it a little bit later. But if you're going to refer people, because it's not always a something where you all work together, but a plumber might work somewhere and they say, hey, we could do with a joiner for this. So if the joiner is in your sphere, you refer the joiner you know, and you expect, there should be an expectancy that they will do the same for you. Otherwise, they shouldn't be in your sphere. They should be in somebody else's. But you get the picture. So contact sphere is a great way to start building a professional business network. And, you know, I also talked about why strategic networking and why nothing really comes from those sessions. Now, you need to be very intentional. See, that is... I said it about this, my story with Arthur, where I was intentional in going to this International Maxwell Certification event. I was very intentional. Now, Arthur is amazing at this. I mean, if I had to recognize somebody who was absolutely brilliant, not only about connecting, but even more so about building long-term relationships, it is certainly Arthur. Arthur Moore, who will be on later on today, you know, you don't want to miss her sessions because they are amazing. As are all the other ones, of course, but I'm a little bit biased with my partner and business partner, Arthur Moore. But you should really do, because the depth of knowledge she has in connecting with people, and that's learned, that didn't just happen overnight. I mean, she's got a passion, a compassion, and an empathy for people anyway that I still am getting to grips with. But when I see it in action, it's unbelievable. And I want to be like that. So if you are in a if you are in one of these contact spheres, and you need to build relationships, you know, for me it is a joy to see it happen. You know, to people sometimes don't get work with each other maybe early on, but then because they build a relationship. See, some people are quickly to say, oh, I spend hours connecting with somebody and then they didn't buy, or they didn't use my service, or they didn't buy my courses. And they forget about them. Never forget about them, because it might not be, they might not need your service now. But if you build relationships with them, not only might they maybe use your services in time, but they will also refer you to other people who will need your services, because they get on with you, they connected with you. I'll talk more into that in number four, in session number four, which is in a few minutes. But it is so important. So you need to be intentional, because that's when you bring real results. Now, people say, yeah, but I've always had good intentions. That's where the difference is, you see. I've also had good intentions. We all have. If you can put your hand up if you have, and I'm sure we can all do that. But people who have good intentions, you heard the saying, the road is paved with good intentions. So I always say, and that's not my quote, but people who have good intentions do something good occasionally. And people who live intentionally do something good continually. So that means that if you are living an intentional life and have an intentional business, that may, you already know in the morning some of the things you're going to do that need to be done today. You know, put it in your Pareto principle, you know, 80-20 rule, that in that 20% you need to make sure that you do the things that really pay off more than the other 80%. Don't do the things you want to do. Do the things you must do. And that you must become intentional about networking. You must become intentional about your goal setting, about what you're going to achieve when you go to a networking session. Otherwise, every time you go to a networking session, they become just another lovely meet and greet job. Oh, I saw this guy again. Lovely guy. Yeah, what does he do? You don't really know. And the other way you can do it is push a business card in somebody and think that's it all done with. Doesn't work either, because then you wonder why the phone doesn't ring off the hook. You just gave out 20 business cards at the last networking session. People put them in the pocket between the other ones. And again, I can't remember everybody who I got business cards from and what they do, and yeah, what it says on the business card, but how to connect with them and why, what they said. So it is better to connect with one or two people strategically, intentionally, than get 20 business cards or give out 20. I mean, you can give out your business cards if people want them, but don't just go hi and hand out a business card. So be intentional about it. And you know, self-leadership is also something what I said is usually lacking. So become more intentional about your growth. Become more intentional about reaching your potential. And if you ever want to achieve your destiny, the only way that's going to happen is growth. I do a program where I've done a video program for the 15 Invaluable Laws of Growth, where I give you a whole program rather than read the book only, where I give you a whole program where you need to go through a growth plan, and the 15 Invaluable Laws is absolutely amazing. So I made it into a video program where you need to do exercises, you need to take action, because a growth plan, it means that you need to take action every single day. You cannot just do that any other way and then wonder why your business is not growing. Or I went to another networking session. Okay, now you know that you need to be intentional. What were the intentions when you went? And you might set intentions, but you need to follow through with it as well, because I set the intentions and nothing happened. So what did you do when you got there? The same as you've always done? Well, you know what the results are, the same as you've always had. So you need to change and become more intentional. And as I said, I've already mentioned Arthur Moore about this, how powerful that lady is in building relationships. But we can all, these are skills we need to learn, because if we can spend 5 minutes with somebody and we be intentional and communicate effectively, we have a better opportunity to connect with them from the heart as well. Because when you talk about all kinds of stuff that everybody talks about in the networking session, apart from the work and all that kind of stuff, it doesn't have to be work-based. You need to connect with people first, but understand before being understood comes here as well. So we really need to connect with people and understand where they come from, listen to them. Listening is the power of listening is quite often underestimated. In fact, we always overestimate our listening skills and underestimate everybody else's, to our disastrous results usually, because we learn a lot more from other people when we listen than when we talk. Now, as a radio show, I can't listen an awful lot, I get that, but I listen to other people as well, and I take notes, and that's also something, you know, have a pen and paper ready, because you know, you can hear something on a networking session that really is necessary. But there is a need for intentional personal development. So if you haven't got a daily growth plan or don't even know what it looks like, you know, find out. I mean, I can help you with that, but find out, because you need, yes, a daily, you hear it every single day. Success is not a one-time thing, it's an everyday thing. You know, and you will be going, if you don't climb a mountain, because success is uphill, if you don't climb a mountain now, you're sliding down a slippery slope, because change will always happen. You don't stand still if you don't know that already. So your choice whether you want to slide down an old hill or climb up a new one. And the hill you're climbing up doesn't have to be big or steep, but whatever you do, put your climbing boots on and start today. So we're already coming on very close to we're already in the last minute again. Wow, how fast this is going. I've not seen any comments now, but if there's people later on, if you listen to the recording, the podcast, which will be uploaded on the IBGR.network as well, if you listen to it or if you watch the video, make comments. I will check them. I will get notified anyway. I will check them. If you've got questions, make them, and you know, I will do my best to answer them. If not straight away, if I don't know, I'll tell you that as well, and I'll come back with an answer, because I love to research these subjects, because it's important to me, and I know it's important to you. And if it's important to you, I will do my best. So, 2 to 3 minute break, and when we come back, we'll talk about networking the Ivan Meisner way. And Ivan Meisner was the founder of the BNI network worldwide. So I will see you. I will be back on the radio in a couple of minutes, and in the Facebook I will keep going. So don't go away. Yeah, and that's a third session over already. Now, whatever you think about, whatever you want to do, whatever you've got out of there already, I hope I've stated enough that networking is important. I've said to you already the kind of things that are not really effective when we just turn up. We need to do more than that. You know, yes, in life you need to turn up, that's a given. There is no networking, and the good thing is networking can be done online as well. Is it as effective? Well, if you actually properly network online, is a lot more, I nearly said a bad word there, or it's a lot more effective than when you are actually turning up on a network session, have a cup of coffee and a muffin or something in your hand, and then nothing happens. So it is as intentional as you decide to be. It is as intentional, it is as effective as you make it to be. It doesn't depend on the other person, because we can't keep doing this. Oh, but he said he would call me. Did you get his card? Did you get his number? If you say, I'll call you in 2 to 3 days. Now leave it 2 to 3 days then. And if he doesn't call you, hey, maybe drop him a mail or even give him a call. You're probably busy. I just want to know, there's so much you can do. You know, but don't leave it to chance. Leave it to choice. Your choice. Now, I hope that makes a bit of sense as well. And as we're going slowly into the last part, I don't even know if we're there already. No. We still have Bill talking on the radio, so I can go a little bit longer because my clock is, I think, 1 minute fast here in the north of Scotland. But yeah, I'm just listening to Bill, and you can hear that. But that's what happens on the radio. They get 2.5 minute break with a little jingly at the end of it, and then I go back on radio. But there we go. See, I'll give you that little jingly because I like my jingle. See, it cheers you up even at 6 o'clock in the morning, nearly 7 o'clock now. Coffee or no coffee, that should wake you up. Okay. I need to turn that off now because we're going live again. And yes, we are back. We are back for our final session. This is IBGR.radio. IBGR is our call sign, and we are a radio station, but we are much more than a radio station. We're an international network. So I'm your host, Jan Roberts, Global Influencer, and this is episode 10. We're talking about your network is your net worth, not your nightmare. And this is in the People Skills Lane at IBGR.network. Now, if you want to download my show notes, go to www.ibgr.network where you can download them already, because Donna has already put them up yesterday. But you can do more than that. You can actually download so much more. You can download our podcast. This one will be at some point in the next couple of days, because there's a lot of them. There's 50 of us now around the world 24/7 with a variety of subjects. So the people behind the scenes are hard at work to make sure you get all the information. And if you can't be live, they will try to be there afterwards for you as well. So the other thing is you can do, we're now on Facebook Live as well. If you're listening, we're also on the IBGR Facebook page live. So you can actually see that face behind radio, that face that was made for radio. But you can do even more. We also have an amazing app. The amazing app we have is, you can now take it on your tablet, your phone, your laptop, but you can listen to us anywhere in the world at any time. You can join the community there. You can find out more about all the different show hosts around the world. There's roughly 50 I talked about. You can download the podcast there too. Download the app. And also, of course, here on Facebook now, like and share this with other people, because it's not just about my Facebook live, but it is more about IBGR's Facebook position, IBGR radio station, where if you share this with people because it's interesting, or it's something that somebody can benefit from, they're struggling with their networking today, they think it's a nightmare because every time they go nothing happens, and they wonder why nothing happens, because surely they're doing their best. Now this last session I'm going to talk a little bit more into some of the ways you can actually network properly. But like and share this with your friends, because we want you all to share this. Real leaders don't keep material to themselves, they share it with others. Be that leader, share with others, and bring everybody into the community. We've already got 145 countries around the world listening every single week. Thank you for that. And hopefully we get more watching now as well. But one of our international Maxwell certification experience in Florida, we had actually the John Maxwell Leadership Awards. We had it the last few years every year. And it was a ceremony. And its recipient that year was the founder of BNI, Ivan Meisner. Now, that he knows a thing about three about networking will never be in doubt. She's with thousands of BNI chapters in many countries around the world, where especially entrepreneurs and business greatly benefit from the weekly networking sessions. Now, I visited several here in Inverness in Scotland, Johannesburg and Durban in South Africa. Their creed, givers gain, is obvious to all who are part of this amazing organization. Now, I'm saying this because there's no financial interest to me to get you to BNI, but Business Network International is an amazing network. You know, especially if you're starting out, go to these networking sessions. You can be invited, find out who's there, find out how you can get invited to one of these sessions and experience what actually happens there. And it's your choice whether you want to become part of this. So Dr. Ivan Meisen actually provided us with so much information and insights on networking skills. But the one that stood out, which really explains the basics of networking very well, I want to share with all of you. And I hope that's okay with you. And if it's not okay, I can't see you nodding on the radio. I can't see you commenting. But there is a pulsating question mark on our website as well, where you can ask questions. And of course, here on Facebook, you can leave comments and ask questions anytime. But the process I'm going to talk into in this last session to give you some real hope and help on how to network more effectively, apart from becoming intentional and the need to build relationships and your communication skills, is the VCP process. Now, you have probably never heard of it, but you will be glad that you listened or watched today, because it's a simple yet very important and profound for all of us. Business owners, family members, in any way of life, this really helps. But if you're an entrepreneur, if you're a startup, if you're a business owner already, see what the VCP stands for. Is V is for visibility, C is for credibility, and P is for profitability. And it is in that order, because networking is much more like farming than like hunting, he was telling us. It's about cultivating, like is farming cultivating, cultivating relationships with other business professionals. Not a get-rich-quick scheme, but a great way to build business through referrals. See, if that that's why I say you need to build a relationship, because if that personal connection doesn't want to buy or has no need for your business services or products or courses, he will certainly might know somebody. There's always a great question, who do you know that I should know? But that maybe is not always the first thing you should ask somebody when you first connect with them. That's why the visibility is there. See, too often people use face-to-face networking as a cold calling opportunity. Hi, my name is Jan Roberts, let's do business. That's a salesy kind of thing, and that doesn't work, people. And they already have a business card in their hand ready to push it into them because they need your business card. But it doesn't work. Networking is about building relationships. That's what VCP is all about. So you have to give, I love this bit, you have to give people your heart before you ask for their hand. Leadership works much better like that. And also building relationships and networking is all about that. So give them your heart before you ask for their hand. Remember that. So it starts with the V, visibility. First, you have to be visible in the community. People have to know who you are and what you do. Now, that doesn't mean that you have to tell them, hey, I'm Jan Roberts. I provide leadership solutions, communications. I do coaching, speaking, training, behavior analysis. No. Hold your horses. They will get to know what you do, but who you are first. Hi, my name is Jan Roberts. It's a pleasure for me to be here. And you know, I'm really interested what kind of people I meet here, because I'm always interested in connecting with like-minded and like-thinking people. And you know, so who are you, and what is it you like, and what wakes you up every morning? It doesn't have to be about business every time, but ask what their habits are, their hobbies are, and those kind of things. And you know, about their family. That is when you build relationships. But when you do so, then you move to the C, credibility. See, where people know who you are, they know what you do, and they know that you're good at it. So they know that because they've seen you operating in business. So that's where the credibility comes in. So the visibility first, and then the credibility. And they know they're good at it because they hear people talking about how good you are. They might actually have used you, so they know firsthand you're good. Now that's credibility. And it takes time to go from visibility to credibility. That's probably the longest part of the whole process. As I said, it's not a get-rich-quick scheme. That's why you need to start early. Don't wait until you desperately need business. See, people do business with those they know, like, and trust. It's a famous saying. So why don't we do this? So Then once you've created credibility, you can go to the third phase, which is profitability. Now, profitability is where people know who you are, they know you're good at it, what you do, and they are willing to give you referrals in an ongoing reciprocal basis. See, too often people assume that they have credibility with their clients because their clients do business with them. But this is a referral process, not a sales process. There's a big difference, people. So the question to ask is, are most of my clients giving me referrals? If the answer is no, you're not at profitability with your own clients. Now, that is something serious. If they say no, you're not at profitability with your own clients. Yes, you had a sale, but you might have credibility because they're using you, but they are not referring you. And what is the reason for that? Because you didn't build a relationship with them. So VCP is about moving through the process and determining where you are in that process, because you must communicate with people differently at every stage. It actually depends where they are as well, of course. At your first meeting, you try to sell. You try to do business before any visibility, which simply does not work. So they call this premature solicitation. I love that, premature solicitation. So remember that. You might laugh at it, but remember it. Don't do it. Sure, it's that premature stuff is no good for you. So, but remember that, premature solicitation. Don't ask for business, give your heart before you ask for the hand, remember? So when you meet for the first time, it's about creating that relationship. When you do, you gradually over time move to credibility. When you're at credibility, you can ask people for referrals. You can start talking more about what you do. You communicate differently with people. In fact, you have the database, but where there is that relationship that you are at with each other, then follow this process through and connect with them at that level. Emails, calls, meetings. Remember, networking is all about farming. You meet people where they are, and you cultivate and you work through the process with the VCP. So I hope that is effective, that talks something about it. There is also the fact that we have you have all kinds of different networks and you are in different nets. Now you need to be in a work net. It includes everybody you work with on a daily basis. You need to have an organizational net that includes people in other divisions and departments of organizations. And you need to be in a professional net, includes professional contacts outside your workplace. And you need to be in a life net, encompasses your family, friends, and even the people you play squash with and that. So I hope that gives you a little bit of an insight and overview. There is so much more, but we are out of time. So there is many more good sessions coming up. Straight after this, it's Tina Ogbugo from Nigeria, then my partner Arthi Moore, and later on Sadiqa Kebbi from Lebanon as well. It's an international network. So if you need help, if you need guidance in leadership, if you need communication help, speaking skills, behavior analysis, you can find me at Key Leadership Institute. It's all in the show notes anyway, where you can find me. But you have been listening to IBGR.network, the International Business Growth Radio Network. I'm your host, Jan Roberts. And I look forward to be with you at the same time, same place, next week, when I'll be talking about consolidating your global influence. So when you are networking and all, how do you consolidate all that? I hope to see you next week. And all I want you to remember, that you are amazing. So go to IBGR.website. Download the show notes. You find all my details there, how to get a hold of me and all the other hosts who are there. So, and don't forget to download the app and like and share Facebook. I look forward to seeing you next week. Remember, you are amazing. Take care. Okay, now that was, I will come off Facebook as well, but very shortly, I'm sure, if Tina is going live as well. She wants to use Facebook as well, and I don't want to interrupt her amazing program. But I hope you got something out of this. Network is important. Building relationships is how you do it. And the VCP process is a way that you can walk through it and become more effective in the way you build relationships. Remember, visibility first, credibility, and then profitability. And what I say is, don't go for the premature solicitation. So that... That, of course, means don't push a business card in somebody's hand the first minute you meet, and then do that. If they push one in your hand, that's fine. They don't know either. But that makes you a better networker by just listening to them, ask them questions about themselves and all that. Build the relationship first. That's how you build visibility. They will ask you eventually what you do anyway, and they'll find out. And if they want your business card, they'll also ask for it. But don't push one in their hand first out. And, you know, I would love to connect with you. Have you got a card? Yeah. And they'll probably ask for yours as well. Here's mine too, you know, just at the end of, but not at the beginning, and build the relationship first. Get networking, people. It's all important to your business and to your clients too. So hopefully it was good. I will see you and next week. Now I need to find out how I can actually switch this off, but have an amazing rest of your Thursday, and, you know, be amazing. Take care.